Hey YouTube, I'm Kenneth Ryan.
I'm Lindsay Resop.
And we're back with another exciting episode of Fanfiction Friday. This week we are continuing to read Clockwork.
If you tuned in last week,
you saw that.
We're going to see where this goes from there.
You saw the storm that was that. Yeah, we're basically going to just jump right in, have some fun, be sad, and figure out what is going on in chapter 30. Who dies and who doesn't? Let's go.
Me?
It's Silver.
Okay. Silver watched, a black scarf wrapped around his nose and mouth to further conceal his features, because he's so recognizable from a child photo.
Right?
Because I mean, the hair color literally... When you're a child, you look completely different, usually.
Right? Like, the number one, the implication that people are going to be able to identify him from an old photograph.
Or that they're going to try to identify him. I mean, besides the bad guys. No, there's no reason for any of the other people to try to help
exactly,
them find him at all.
There's no incentive.
Yeah, they're not going to let them live or anything, like we mentioned last time, I think.
Exactly.
For the concealed features, still moving swiftly along the narrow gut works of the stadium. Gut works?
Okay.
Like inner workings?
I'm guessing.
Better. Somewhat shocked and horrified at how easily Gold cut down the grunts, swinging his makeshift weapon into arms and legs, not caring if he broke them. They're, well, they're trying to kill you!
Considering they're trying to kill you, I don't think it's... Okay.
And you're surprised that Gold finds it easy to hurt people?
Like, wasn't it like chapter 3 or 4 or somewhere around there where fucking Gold and Red got into a fist fight and Red kicked Gold's ass or something?
He kicked him in the face pretty much.
Like... Whatever.
It's like, they're used to violence. They get in fights all the time.
Right?
Like, he cares if he's breaking the arms of people who are trying to kill you.
Exactly.
They seemed like easy fodder. They wore hard-brimmed caps, and Silver assumed that the ones who wore hoods were higher ranked, and thus harder to beat.
But, okay.
Cat.
Whatever.
Sure. Okay. The hard-capped grunts didn't stand a chance in Gold's rampage, obviously undertrained in the way they lashed out haphazardly with their knives and tasers, trying to bring down the angry teen. So let's just not train our army of people to how to fight while we're taking over.
Right.
A competition where, like, 20 of the people are, like, masters at martial arts.
Thank you. It's like, excellent point.
They're athletes.
Right.
In a fighting competition, kind of.
That's fine.
Blah, blah, blah.
It's right at the top.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was like...
You'd scroll down when I looked at
oh,
it.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
Jake, stop licking the camera stand. That's my cat, not a, like an actual person named Jake. The reason for this minor rage was Gold. What? After sitting and watching thousands die, was thoroughly pissed off. Okay. He hated seeing innocents die for no reason.
Yeah, okay. No shit. So he's a decent human being, and he is appalled by senseless violence. Amazing
then
how that
works.
He
wanted to see someone from the opposition get hurt. Kind of still senseless violence, but not really.
But it's also self-defense-ish.
And whilst Silver didn't want anyone to get hurt, this was Team Rocket. He jumped over the prone bodies as Gold cleared the way for them to reach the arena, where they'd free the trapped athletes as they dodged small firework-like crackers that rained down on them and could potentially kill them if caught in the blast.
Hold on.
How are they small and
what?
People are, like, dropping, like, little tiny bomb things.
Okay, whatever.
That are, like, fireworks. Go. I guess.
Whatever.
A sick parody of the game of dodgeball that had never happened.
Yeah, that's exactly
why
what
is
this
dodgeball
is.
In like
dodgeball? Because
it's not like
dodge
bomb. It's like the singular, you know, whatever. A dodge bomb.
We'll put a laser on the moon. I think that's how it goes. I don't remember. I haven't
seen.
It's
probably a double, but whatever.
Oh yeah.
Gold dodged the knife and zipped at him, sinking into the wall behind him. How does a knife sink into the wall? Aren't these, like, concrete walls, first of all?
It's a stadium, so yes.
And it's, like, in the inner, like, basement. Not basement, but, like, inside. Those are, like, okay.
Okay, no. No.
Parrying the next knife with the bar, he knocked the man unconscious with the butt end of the metal. I thought he had a bat. And that probably my bat. The red mark left looked like it would bloom into a healthy bruise later. Jake, get off the computer.
You're not gonna walk on our device.
Gold splattered with the blood from his enemies, from their noses as they bled all over him.
specifically their noses.
That sentence doesn't really make sense, but okay.
It also was unnecessary.
Gold was splattered?
Whatever. I don't even feel like we need to know that it was
Silver had asked why gold always aimed for the nose. Gold hadn't had an answer to that, merely stating it was the easiest way to disable a person without permanently injuring or causing massive bodily harm to them. If you hit someone in the nose, you can kill them!
Also...
because it'll, like, shove it into their brain, like, the bone part fragments and stuff.
Also, children...
what are you doing?
Children of the fan fiction. This is a terror attack! These people are not good people! I mean, like,
I mean, sure, he doesn't want to kill people.
Like, I get you don't want to kill them, but, like, there comes a point...
massive bodily harm.
Where, like... obviously, these people have an intent to, like, kill you. Like, I don't see you not killing them as necessarily taking a moral higher ground. You know what I'm saying? Does that make sense? Like, I don't know.
You could get arrested afterwards, maybe.
Yeah, if this country doesn't have self-defense laws, but... but, like, whatever, whatever.
Yeah, but literally, you can kill someone by bashing their nose in, like... you send, like, fragments, like, straight into their brain is pretty much what you're doing there. Yeah, also the temple. bodily harm to them. A broken nose and a blow to the head would heal. Maybe not.
There's a good chance, no.
Brain damage, concussions.
Ooh.
Whatever. Whereas if you tried stabbing them with the pole, if that was a bat, if you did so hard enough, which Silver didn't doubt Gold could... he could potentially kill a person by bashing in their chest.
He could also kill them by bashing in their brain.
Or, yeah, okay. Plus, it took too long to do that. Thus, bringing the nose was much quicker. And the irony of it was, whilst it was the cleanest method of defeating the opponent, it wasn't, in reality, as blood would fountain everywhere. What? Oh, why?
I've got nothing.
The last chapter was like, the mothers holding their dead children and stuff, and now this chapter is like, what the fuck?
Here's how Gold is disabling his enemies in a very violent, bloody way.
Three different paragraphs. What are you doing, Cat? Oh my god. Don't break my blinds. He's gonna bend them.
Probably.
That bowl is really old and gross. Don't lick it. Oh.
Okay. We'll throw them out soon.
Yeah. blah, blah, blah. It wasn't.
Flint was
pushing Riley along in the wheelchair, his afro sooty and his face streaked with sweat. Is this the other black guy?
No.
Oh, no.
He's
a ginger. What? Oh, God. We need to get them out of here.
Yeah, we will. It's okay.
Between takes.
We will.
Blah, blah, blah. His handkerchief wrapped round the wound on his arm. Silver held the baseball bat.
I don't remember him getting hurt, but okay.
In the explosion.
Oh, right.
Wasn't the, like, a, he, didn't he get hit by, like, a piece of shrapnel that almost killed him? And then
the shrapnel that
hit people behind.
It almost killed him and then definitely killed the people behind him.
Oh, my God, Kat.
We're fine. It's okay.
I know. It's bothering me. He's making noise and, like, knocking that cup off the deck. Anyways.
He's going to knock the Taco Bell down.
Oh, God, don't do that. That is not...
okay, read to focus.
Oh, God. Silver held the baseball bat, unsure the wheelchair... unsure what Gold wanted him to do with it as he kept up to pace. Flint waved to the stocky teen, halting their small party.
Oh, my God.
Oh, like, party as in group, not like...
Silver held the baseball bat, unsure what Gold wanted him to do with it. So, like, Gold gave you a baseball bat for self-defense, buddy. That's what he wants you to do with it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's why you have it.
He wants you to, like, hit people in the face with it.
Oh, my God. Anyway,
sorry, my hair is like...
No, it's fine. It's just, I had an itch.
Blah, blah, blah. I kept a pace. Flint waved to the stocky teen holding their small party. Silver and Flint on the lookout as Gold opened the door. They'd have to do this fast. The athletes were the centre of attention. And thus, everyone, especially that Petrel, would notice them escaping.
Who is Flint? I'll be Flint.
How is this musing, first of all?
Right.
You can be Flint. Well, we'll just end up...
get ready to run, Flint mused.
Characters are probably going to change person and voice
all the time.
In this chapter, at least.
All the time. Flint mused. They had
mused.
They had planned to open the door of the west stand that entered the arena and get all the athletes back as they were swarmed with Team Rocket.
Was the west stand intact still?
I think it was
the east stand that blew up, or the south stand, or the east and south stand, and then the north stand?
I think it was the east and south.
Is the west one the only one that's still intact?
I think so. I don't know, though. Okay. We're gonna get these cats out of here, because they're really distracting us. We'll be
Sorry.
Right back. Gold wrenched the door open with a savage wrench and a harsh primal growl. Silver did not think it was sexy in the slightest. Nope, not at all. And if he was, now was not the time to be thinking such trivial things. You're damn right, Silver. You're damn right.
He wouldn't think that. Like, oh, just like, oh, we're about to be attacked because we're gonna go try and save these athletes. Dang, that was sexy. Whoops.
Right? Okay, like, right? I have never known a single person who's in a life or death situation that's thinking about how someone else is really hot right now. Things are thinking like, am I gonna die? Like, is this the end?
Is he gonna die? Is everyone else gonna die? How many people are gonna die?
Oh my god. Blah, 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 blah. Falling from his lips as he took... So they put a period in the parenthesis, but they continued the thought. You know, yeah. A savage wrench... Like, that looks wrong.
Well, that's because it was like, there were, like, three sentences. Okay.
A harsh primal growl. Falling from his lips as he turned the metal pole that he had jammed into the circular wheel lock. It was magnetized and would be hard to force open, as it worked with a coil spring mechanism as well. Riley whimpered, pathetic and fearful, hating his uselessness, as a couple of grunts, upon hearing them, began to call for reinforcements. Great. That was great character building for Riley.
Yeah, he's fearful and pathetic in a wheelchair because he hurt his leg and he's gay.
Pretty much. Began to call for reinforcements, the other That's one grabbing Flint in a headlock. Silver acted on upon his own accord. Period. Lashing out with the bat, the two grunts fell with solid thumps. Gold smirked at him, and Silver dropped the bat in shock at what he had just done.
Why is Silver in shock? He hasn't really fought anyone, but...
What the frick frack is going on? Also, I hate frick frack, and I feel gross having said that, but okay. Whilst he had been able to hurt himself, Silver had never been good at hurting others. Flint, after thanking him, grabbed the bat, laying two heavier smacks down as the dazed rocket duo groggily looked up. They fell prone as the afro-haired man sent them off into dreamland, possibly in a coma.
Unconsciousness.
Possibly killing them.
Yeah.
Anyways, which, by the way, when I say that, I'm not saying it like it's bad that they possibly killed them. I'm just saying...
It's kind of bad.
But again, life or death situation, you're going to do some crazy shit. Yeah. But, like, my point, you know, remember, there are 40,000 people confirmed dead, apparently, so...
Like, if they do end up killing a couple people, like, accidentally, it's like, okay, that's not their fault, really.
Yeah.
But if they don't have to, I suppose.
Like, I get, like, how they're avoiding it, but whatever. It's just, like...
Then they're gonna come to consciousness, and then they're just kind of sitting there, not incapacitated in any way, except just knocked out.
Right? Silver said nothing as he took the bat back, his jaw trembling... The fact he had just fought back made this personal and real.
What? It wasn't personal before. They're trying to find you. You're the reason that this is all happening. It's all your fault.
Oh my god.
It's not his fault.
I mean, like...
It's his father's fault.
It is his father's fault.
Who's dead. Hopefully.
Hopefully. Flint had drafted a plan to get them all into a storm room. They locked from the inside, so if... They ended up being cornered like rats. They would have some time to prepare for the inevitable invasion. Cool. Gold, with massive effort, opened the door.
I thought he already opened the door.
It rolled open with a hiss, grabbing the air horn from Riley. Flint stepped out slightly into the dusty floor and pressed the button of the horn. The signature whistling foghorn like beep! Peep! The frog sounded, and all the athletes... turned like startled rabbits. Morty screaming as in his split moment of broken concentration was struck by the exploding firecracker that snapped angrily as it blew up a few feet away from him. The hard casing of the tiny missiles embedding into his skin.
Is he dead?
Morty! Oh, jeez, Rick. Oh, jeez, I don't know if I can do it. Don't know if I can do this anymore.
Like, what is good? Oh, God.
I'm very confused.
I'm very confused.
I'm honestly trying my best to follow this, but I'm struggling. But okay, Morty's... Okay. Possibly dead.
Possibly.
Gold stood back, holding the door open as the representative sprinted through. Some singed. That's the word. I was like, singed? What? Some singed and others with cuts. Silver was whisked into a protective hug by Green, who held him tightly.
Oh god, holy fuck, you can't be, we cannot let them have you! You're yelling this, oh, Yay, there's like Team Rocket members surrounding you. This is the person we can't let you have right here.
Better not take him.
Green swore, and Silver gingerly reached up to free himself. The brunette was on the verge of hysterics, his face streaked with soot, his eyes wild, his hands shaking. Yeah, that's literally everyone.
That's shock?
Yeah.
Legit.
Red stood beside him, calm and poised, a long cut down his face. How did... Oh, I guess things are flying from above as well. They were crowded in the hallway and needed to move. How'd they get into the hallway? So wait, were they in the center?
So wait, is Morty, like, dead? Like, for sure? Because I feel like if he was, someone might have carried him, but they're not mentioning
anything. He's apparently just dead. I don't know.
Cool.
They're not even mentioning. He just screamed and he got embedded in his skin.
Okay.
So we're just going to assume he's dead.
Much like all the other people.
I guess. The black one, is Morty gay too?
Yes, because he's Faulkner.
Morty and
God, this is so...
Everyone.
Everyone.
All the minorities.
Jeepers.
I mean, they're kind of the majority with the gay ones here. But...
Yeah, in a fanfiction, it's the majority of the jeepers.
Blah, blah, blah. Crowded in the hallway and needed to move. With a strangled yell, Gold released the door, and it slammed back into place, the wheel lock whirring as it spun into its original locked form. The many athletes turning to exclaim thanks, but Brawley's voice rose thick above the din, choked with sorrow for their fallen champion. Champion or champions?
Oh, Steven. He's from the... Okay, so Steven is dead. Steven is dead. Because Steven is the champion from the games that he is from. So yes, Steven's dead. Thank you for that weird roundabout way. Who is Brawley?
I don't know.
I think it was you, actually. So just Brawley it up.
It was just the one where I was like, I don't know.
He's like the bro-y dude.
I don't know. Guys, we have company.
Yes. Yes.
He's yelling. Flint cursed, just as predicted. They were going to be... Why did they say Flint curse without having Flint actually cursed?
Right.
Whatever. They were going to be pressurized. Pressurized?
I think they meant pursued.
Pressurized by an insane amount of team members clad in black, but you got them through the door and they're all on the other side.
Okay.
Where are the... How did the people on the inside know that they're... I don't know. Who knows? Gold, not having much time to grab the pole before hustling the group along as they were pursued. Green stood back, his eyes blazing, his lips drawn in a feral snarl. I thought he was just in shock. Now he's just like, I'm gonna kick your asses. And Gold, realizing the silly brunette was going to try taking them all on alone, grabbed him, dragging him along. They had no choice but to flee. Silver looked back, adjusting his makeshift mask, and one grunt pointed at him. That grunt wore a hard-brimmed hat with a silver lining. His gloves were made of a more expensive leather than the cheap latex-looking ones the others wore. So, a hard-hatted grunt with...
That's nice gloves.
Higher ranked than the other grunts, but lower ranked than the ones in hoods.
I guess.
I don't know. Silver quickly noted how the rest of the rocket pack wore factory-made and standard uniforms. Strange. Silver never recalled Team Rocket having such a specific uniform.
Oi, that one, the black hood and scarf round his face, that's the boss's son. Gold, who was only footsteps behind the silvery-eyed team, grabbed the bat from his faltering grasp and turned swinging the wooden slab into a vicious slash into the lead grunt's face, crushing his nose and splitting his lip in a magnificent, sickening thud.
He's dead.
Probably. Dropping the bat as the onslaught continued, trampling over their fallen leader, Gold fled. Oh, the fallen Team Rocket leader, got it.
Yeah.
Following the escaping group of athletes as they sped down the narrow corridor before Flint veered off and they all tumbled exhausted into the large equipment room at the end of the west stands. Locking the door, Flint quickly did a head count, noting that a few were missing as they were dot 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 dead. So who? Okay. Faulkner was holding Morty up.
Hey, Morty's alive!
Morty's alive! Faulkner was holding Morty up, who looked like a mess. Who looked a mess. Half his face and shoulder was a torn, bloody maze of slashed flesh, and Claire stood...
Flesh.
Slashed flesh? Did I say fresh?
Yeah.
Wow. Slashed fresh.
Slash.
Thank you. And Claire stood by... Stood by her face...
By, comma, probably.
Stood by. Her face actually twisted in worry as she carefully plucked shrapnel out of the blonde gymnast's wound. Wallace looked as bloodless as Riley... as did Roxanne, both wishing it had been them entirely that had taken the blow for Steven, who now lay cold on the arena floor where they'd left him, his body riddled with cruel straps of metal and glass. You just really want to drive the point that he is fucking dead. Wow.
So he's the only one besides...
I think Misty's for sure.
I think Lenora.
Lenora, Steven, and I think Misty. We're like supposed
she was,
to assume.
Yeah, she was bleeding, but they didn't... it wasn't confirmed.
Steven, who now lay cold.
Yeah. On the arena floor. God. And left him.
Gold came over. I know, it's like, jeez.
Metal and glass.
God. Gold came over to Silver, who looked up at the taller, dark-haired male, worried. Gold wordlessly held out a pair of scissors. Silver.
Is he cutting his hair?
Oh, I think so. What
will these do? Silver whispered, pulling down the scarf from his face so he could breathe properly, and Gold bit his lower lip. Silver watched how shadows played across Gold's face, intense as the large equipment room was dark with no lights on, and the dim lighting made everything much more dramatic, the power having been cut in this part of the stadium. This is Gold.
It'll stall them for a brief moment. Silver shook his head.
No, those other grunts got a pretty good look at me. Short hair or not, they'll recognize me. But no, only one guy.
It was one. Group, I guess. Okay, but here's the thing. Like,
you had a scarf over your face.
A drastic haircut will change how you look. It's gonna stall them. It will work.
Probably.
Because it's really hard. Like, if someone goes from long hair to super short hair, you're gonna do a lot of double takes before you're like, is that who I think it is?
Yeah.
God.
Short hair they'll recognize me. No doubt they'll have command of the cameras. Upon realizing there were cameras... Flint and Volkner immediately set about blocking or destroying the ones present in their hiding spot. Why are there cameras in the storage rooms?
I don't understand why they're just now discovering that there are cameras.
There are cameras everywhere. Well, remembering there are cameras.
Maybe. Oh, I guess. True. Okay,
but
so.
But this is realizing for Flint and Volkner, at least.
They're slow, but that's fine. Because I felt like, you know...
How did Team Rocket get past all these cameras?
Good question. The union sucks.
Or, like, I guess, like, the security guard might have been in on it. Who knows?
Anyways.
Guards, like, the billions of them that are the army.
So, set out to blocking or destroying. I think it was you.
We were just going too early on and ferreted out. I think, yeah, it was me, I think. I remember saying Volkner. Also discovered too early on and ferreted out. Whitney, now all pale, peeked out of the blinds. Her lip was... Why are there blinds in a storage room? What...
that doesn't make sense, honestly.
There aren't windows, usually. Her lip was split from hitting the ground hard and her hair a mess. Splinters of light slanting through the slats of the metal blinds as the combat specialist from Johto peered out the window.
Fuck.
Slanting? Oh, God.
Who the hell was Lance? Oh.
It's probably me, but I have no idea.
Fucking a voice? Shit. What's the deal with bagging peanuts? What does it look like out there? Lance, what does it look like out there? Lance asked, half his face a model of green bruises, and his hands a mess of bloody cuts from where he'd hit the ground too hard and scraped them. Whitney shook her head, seemingly mute. Red looked out as well. Is this Red saying this?
No, that's probably Whitney. I doubt Red is going to say, oh god, no, that's a child.
Oh, true. Okay, so you can be Whitney, I guess.
Oh, bad. Bad. They're killing people one by one. Oh god, no, that's a child.
Shit.
I think I was Volkner, honestly, but you can do it.
Oh, I just took it because I was like, here, I'll keep it.
You can be Volkner, yeah.
Volkner came over with
a
camera.
He was like, weirdly Italian, kind of Russian.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah, no, you gotta do it now, because you remember.
I don't remember.
You remembered
how,
your
I don't
voice.
I remember what it sounded like. I just remember that it sounded vaguely Italian slash Russian slash Italian.
Well, next time he speaks, you can do it. Volkner came over with a camera that he'd torn out of the ceiling with a screwdriver, his expression no longer moody.
Or is Red the one saying shit? I don't know.
But agitated concern as he tossed the useless item away. The blonde looked out the window through the small gap in the blinds to see a line of people in the arena, each one going to their death. Red...
They're just, like, executing people in a line. There's, like...
Why are these people fighting back?
Yes, Why? That. Why? If they're executing you, try and run.
Try to do something. God.
you can't just stand around and be like, I hope that someone saves us before it's my turn to be executed in this line that's slowly moving towards our death.
God. Red turned to them all.
I highly doubt they're like 40,000.
Right.
Team Rocket members.
Red turned to them all, his lips barely moving. God, who's responding even? You can just make a voice for that second line, okay? We need to do something.
Like what?
What about the army?
Skyla whispered, deeply shaken by the loss of her friend Lenora. Drayden
so
let out
Lenora's
a...
So Lenora's dead.
Yeah.
And...
Drayden and let out a cynical laugh.
Drayden is dead.
You can be Drayden. I don't think he's had a voice yet.
I mean, the other one was kind of like a high-pitched thing, so...
Can you try to sound like Bernie Sanders? Because Drayden
sounds
like...
I don't know
like,
what Bernie Sanders
Because Drayden
really
sounds like Dreidel, and this is, like, super
I can't do that. I don't know what Bernie Sanders even sounds like, really. I don't remember. I mean, I've heard him do his...
I can't remember either, honestly.
They cannot help us! Any outside help, they will be blown sky high. I highly doubt they'll reach us from the air, as it's too dangerous. They could end up killing Nor. Either way, this Team Rocket must have known about the army beforehand and somehow subdued them. Everyone knew about the army, and how do you subdue the army? How do you subdue the army? How? Claire turned to look at Silver with her piercing blue eyes, and Silver glared back defiantly.
This is stupid. This line is fucking dumb. Claire, you are a dumb. You're dumb. Just saying. Yeah.
They said they were looking for him. Why not just...
Give him up? You must be fucking nuts! Green stepped up into her personal space, his teeth bared. Yeah, there's no reason for you to give him
Because they're
them.
Still gonna kill you, they literally said.
They literally said, oh, we'll spare you. LOL, JK, we're not gonna do that. Fuck that.
You won't kill y'all anyway.
Everyone in this
so,
building.
Bye. Oh
my Claire God. Stepped back, her eyes narrowed as if she still liked the idea anyway. Green, not missing this little tidbit, eyeballed her aggressively. Silver felt a glow of affection for the brunette psychologist who was defending him with all he had, as always, putting others before himself. Claire looked away with a small hiss. Who responded?
Oh, okay, I think it's a back and forth between Claire and Green. I'm gonna make
Clay,
it
Clay, I think.
Clay?
Clay is this last line.
Oh.
And I doubt Green is gonna call him the boy.
Okay, fine, so it's Claire and Clay. You can be Clay, because I already...
I don't understand. I can't do voices.
I'm pulling them out of my ass.
It was merely a suggestion to stop all the unnecessary carnage.
We do not have to give up the boy!
And would it harm us not to?
He is still one of us, Claire!
Jesus.
Clay boomed, and Jasmine sat on the floor, nursing her torn feet. She looked up, her face set in a miserable scowl.
Oh, God, because Green speaks, I'll be Jasmine.
I think we should. They'll leave.
What? Leave us alone? Green stood over her, his emerald eyes alight with fury. Jasmine quickly looked away, and Faulkner, ripping off one of his sleeves, used it to bind Morty's shoulder, the blonde hissing the whole time.
Yeah, honey, you got shrapnel in your arm. It's not gonna be fun fixing that.
Yeah.
Stop being a little bitch.
He's hissing because of Faden. You're like, stop being a little bitch. He's got shrapnel in his arm and face. Inside and face.
Comedy. Oh my god.
Silver swallowed as Gold viciously stabbed the scissors point down into a wooden shelf.
Oh, Roar. God.
Is this...
Roark.
Oh.
Muttered, so...
Roark.
We're just giving the Snape voice, so here we go.
We're all going to die. Let's face it, they said it themselves. We're all going to be blown sky high anyway, so what's the point of doing anything?
Roark muttered, standing heavily on one leg as he leant on his father Byron. Green turned to him, his eyes narrowed dangerously.
No, we aren't! They'd be baiting us! Bluffing!
How would you know, Oak? Flannery, all fiery hair
and characters.
Beautifully... All fiery haired and beautiful stepped forwards, her strong voice quivering as
Why
she continued.
Why is she beautiful?
We lost Stephen's sound to them! They are not fucking around! Green shook his
head. They killed Steven. They're clearly going to kill us all, and they're not bluffing about having a giant bomb to blow us all up.
Oh, this is the worst, honestly.
Their logic. I mean, yes, in like situations like this, you can't be logical sometimes, but they're just kind of really stupid.
It's really illogical. Green shook his head, and Red placed a hand on his shoulder, telling the handsome psychologist to step down. Taking a deep breath, Green backed away, his hand dipped to show head his dipped. Respect. His head dipped to show his respect.
I'm going to back away my leash.
Flannery said nothing, turning away before spotting Riley and immediately made a beeline for the heartbroken man. Silver couldn't look Riley in the eyes any longer.
Why was he looking him in the eyes in the first place? Was he just staring at him there?
So you can be Bugsy!
I think we should try evacuating the stadium by air! Bugsy piped up, but was immediately shot down. Many calling him naive and idiotic.
Him?
Suggesting something so ridiculous. How are they going to get out by air? I mean, yes, that's kind of
it's
a thing.
It's a thought, though. God.
But, oh, we should turn him over for no reason, just because they're looking for him. And maybe they'll leave us alone, even though they said they'd kill us all. We should evacuate by air, maybe. No, you're stupid. What's wrong with you? I guess. Another idea was shot down from Price, who had suggested that they lay low until it calmed. Why not? Red snorted softly as he watched the proceedings. They were all going to tear each other's throats out the longer this continued.
You can be this one because the responses are coming from Faulkner. So I'm Faulkner.
Okay.
So you get to be the one that's yelling, I guess.
I still boys! Boy, we give up the boy!
Never! No. Never in a million years!
Why not? You're still a kid. You wouldn't understand.
Yes, I do.
Prove it, Archer boy.
Because Silver's my friend.
You wouldn't understand. Yes, I do. Prove it. Silver's my friend. He's my friend. Why?
Why? Why? Honestly, why?
That comes. That response. You're just a child. You would not understand this. This magical thing that was...
There you go. That's Faulkner.
Faulkner.
God.
This magical thing that was... life.
Faulkner replied, his voice contorted in fear and pain as he found, or rather Morty found, a long piece of metal that had grazed the archer on the hip, cutting a deep, nasty lesion. His chest heaving as the gymnast cleaned the wound usually. With some rubbing alcohol he had found. Good.
Yeah?
I mean, that's good. Yeah. And actually, it makes sense. You would probably find that in a...
storage closet.
Yeah. Faulkner, Flint, and Cynthia were... Oh, Cynthia's still alive! Oh my god, this is the best day of my life. I love her, and I'm so glad she's still living. This is where she dies, and I'm gonna cry so much. Okay, Faulkner, Flint, and Cynthia were arguing with Lance and the rest of the Jonto team, both with mixed opinions on the matter, and who the fuck Team Rocket were...
Where?
And what their... Where? Oh, where? And what their true goals or objectives were...
Where is
Claire's
where
voice rose above the squabbling, and Gold, who had been staring Norman of Hoenn down, looked like he was ready to start a fight, stopped, startled.
So this one's Claire, I think. No, wait, that's one of those two.
It's Maylene or Whitney. We already have a Whitney voice.
Which one was Whitney?
You were Whitney.
Was Whitney the high one that I just...
Yeah, Claire's voice rose above. Gold had been staring, looked like he was gonna start a fight.
So Claire is that one, and then that one. I don't... Just say words.
Okay, I think this is a back and forth between Claire and Gold. So that's what I'm gonna make it.
So am I
You're
gonna
pathetic.
Do this one?
Yeah. Okay. You're pathetic. Excuse me? Fucking Norman. I'll just do the him as this one. I wonder what would happen if...
They're piling the bodies of the dead in the arena, guys!
Oh my god.
Maylene and Whitney were glued to the window, trying their very best not to look, but unfortunately transfixed by the gruesome act of the strange, bow-legged man, his expression glee-filled as he extracted a young boy's tongue with a swift ripping motion with his knife, blood spurting thickly as the boy dropped, writhing in pain, choking, unable to scream. You can scream without a tongue, first of all. But also, what the fuck?
What?
I mean, yes, it was mentioned earlier that he liked ripping out tongues, but why?
Why did you... Author, you made a creative decision, KTX Rebel Cut, to make the person whose tongue got cut out a young boy. Why? Why? Why?
Writhing pain, choking, and unable to scream. You can scream without a tongue. It's not like you ripped out his vocal cords. You can't, like, speak very well without a tongue, because you can't, like, form the sound, the mouth forms for the words. But still, Claire shoved Candace away from her in disgust. Why?
Okay.
Oh, was that Candace that was saying that? I don't know. Byron, who had been nearby, swore at the blue-haired lady, but she ignored him as she raised her hand.
All in favor of giving up the damned boy. You can Wallace. Be Wallace.
We're not handing Silver over to them! That's like the fucking death sentence!
Ooh, Wallace spat, all grace and nobility gone from him, as he became something wild and beautiful.
Why are they all still beautiful?
Why are they all beautiful?
That, like, everything, like, Flannery is beautiful, but and, fiery.
Yeah,
like,
he is wild and beautiful.
And it's like, shut up.
Hair in disarray, and his voice passionate as he defended the son of Giovanni. Brawley, shaking his head as he disagreed with Fantina and Wake,
oh, I like Fantina.
Who threw their arms up as if the fighter was a lost cause. So they raised their hands? Gold, did you say you're all in favor and they're raising their hands because of that?
I guess.
Gold held on to Silver's hand tightly. Silver was shaking, knowing fully that these athletes, if they so chose to give him up, could easily take him and Gold or Green wouldn't be able to stop him. To easily take him and Gold or Green wouldn't be able to stop them.
If you go, I'm going with you. The hawk-eyed male. Hey, I guess this is the first time that I can be happy that I know what his eyes are like, so I knew whose voice that fucking was. Yeah. The hawk-eyed male whispered, and Silver shook his head and narrowed his eyes at his lover before smacking him gently. Gold did not look at him, his jaw working silently as the redhead spoke.
No, I'll go alone if it's decided that I must give myself up. Fuck that.
I'd be like, no, bitches, bye, out, see ya.
You and the rest, however, need to get out of here. Gold said nothing and looked determinedly ahead. He did, however, squeeze Silver's hand tightly, not letting go once. Red stood on the side quietly with Brock and Blaine, who looked exhausted. Volkner was livid as Gardania and Cylan and Sabrina explained how none of them could afford to allow any more people to die. Flint made a sharp movement as he told Koga and Janine, hey, they're alive, that they couldn't just surrender. The fighting and arguments, if you surrender, they're gonna kill you.
Yeah, you can't.
So if you give him up, they're gonna kill you.
There's no winning. There's, like, no winning right now.
They're all so stupid. Blah, blah, blah. Couldn't just surrender. The fighting and arguments escalated louder and louder, so you're drawing attention to yourselves. Yeah. Gold pulled Silver close to his being, glaring at anyone who so much looked their way, ready to defend Silver if worst came to worst. The door burst open in a shower of familiar sparks. It exploded? Because, I mean, the door was locked. They, like, blew up the door, I guess. There's sparks somehow. Roxanne screamed, and Flint and Volkner turned, startled. Wallace dropped Rourke, who hissed. I thought Rourke was leaning on Byron or whatever. Who hissed, and Cynthia turned away from Flannery, who kicked out at Bugsy, who'd been trying to tell her something.
Okay, so this isn't your voice.
This is a woman.
I want to do it. She has a high forehead like me. Is this Jessie?
Hilarious.
This is Jessie! No, it totally is. Okay. Ha ha! Caught in your little hidey hole like itty bitty micey. Ah! Now isn't this nice?
It's Ariana is her name, I guess.
A woman with a high forehead and blood red hair that swept over her shoulders in a luxurious curl, Jessie, stepped through wearing an elegant uniform with a slit up the side exposing her leg and deadly looking heels. That's how Jessie looks. Silver peeked from under his hood and under Gold's arms, saw with much horror that this woman, this higher executive Team Rocket, was Ariana, his stepmother.
His stepmother.
So, what a cozy little gathering is this. So, what do we have here? She stepped forwards, flanked by two higher-ranked rocket guards. One of them was that broken-nosed one that Silver, with the silver-lined hat, he seemed to be inspecting the doorway, sticking something down on the wall. Several others filed in through the door. How big is this storage space? Filed in through the doorway, slowly advancing on the cornered athletes with smug looks on their faces. They too were higher ranked. Silver hid his face, praying that no one gave him up, praying that it wouldn't end just like that. Gold knows how half the room of athletes moved slightly to cover them. Gold only hoped the enemy didn't think Silver was with them. Green sidled up and stood next to them, his voice tense and a betraying... And
it's not Jessie, it's this lady.
Okay. Interesting.
It's not a curl, but okay.
Whatever.
Gold sidled up and stood next to them, his voice tense and betraying a slight quaver in his glossy eyes.
His eyes glossy.
Search clothes with me, Silver!
Oh my god.
What?
That's not gonna work.
Silver hissed, and Green put a finger to his lips. You're changing in the middle of the room, and people just standing there watching you guys. Volkner and Flint staring at the psychologist as he was mad.
They're gonna know.
As he explained his idea, he's gonna have a hood on, I guess, and he'll be like, it's me. They're not gonna have him prove it, and his hair is gonna be brown, and he's like, what the fuck's wrong with you people? You're so stupid. As he explained his idea, Cynthia stood at the head of the group, and the blood-haired woman stared the petite Sinnoh champion down. Cynthia glared up at her. Is Cynthia gonna die? Her blue gaze steady and unwavering. A harsh slap rang out as Cynthia staggered back. So, why does the randomly just slap Cynthia? Because she's staring at her. Okay. Shoot her or something. A dark welt flashing across her cheek in a nasty red-pink color. That is too quickly.
Oh, by the way, I claimed Cynthia, so it's going to be a lot of me talking. Remember that.
Ariana shook her hand slightly and smiled, simpering at Cynthia, who tasted blood. Spitting roughly, Cynthia squared her shoulders. Ariana adjusted her ring with a sigh.
I just like it when people look at me so insolently. Well, as you all know, we're looking for Team Rocket's heir. He's a stubborn, depressing lad. I was told that he was with you lot. Oh, shoot, what voice did I want to do with her? Oh my god, what voice did I want to do with her?
I don't know.
Shoot, I had one.
She's little.
She's a badass. She's my favorite. He's not here. It's gonna sound exactly the same, but I don't care. Cynthia ground out and Ariana looked at her pityingly. Little girl.
That's just the way you just said that just made me think of, like, Angel, your character.
My character that I played?
Yes. And then Angel went, he's not here. It doesn't matter.
Bye. Oh my god, Cynthia ground out.
What?
What? Yeah, you're pathetic. Blah, blah, blah. Paragraph after paragraph, she saw the script the day before, or the day of filming.
Yeah, I'm
sorry, I looked at your orange chicken crotch. It's a good blooper. Anyways, check out my short film, Angel. It's on this channel. It's really good.
Inhaling saliva.
Little girl, I know when I smell a lie, and I know you are lying. No, where is he? Cynthia had to hold back Wake as he made a move as if to deck the Team Rocket executive on the face to send her through the wall for slapping his champion. Green, thankful that Lance and Chuck were so broad to hide them, as he quickly slid out of his shirt and pulled on Silver's hoodie, frantically brushing his spiked hair down to mimic Silver's long hair, pulling the hood up and tying the scarf around his face. Green could probably pass as the redhead, albeit a bit taller, unless one looked closely, and probably only for a split second. But if Green's plan worked, that was all the time they needed. Volkner and Flint stood by, looking like it was the last thing they wanted to do, as they were supposed to be the two that gave Silver, a.k.a. Green, up to Team Rocket. Gold, however, held Green back. Red was on the other side of the room, oblivious. Green closed his eyes. And...
wait, what? I don't understand what just happened.
Neither do I.
Was I reading?
Ariana pulled out a small device. No, I was reading.
Yeah.
You see this here? It explodes upon contact with a human being after activation.
That makes no sense.
It works with body temperature.
That doesn't make sense!
I could just blow you all up and you can kiss your butts goodbye.
If it was like a really warm day, it'll just blow up.
Exactly.
It's like, oh, it explodes upon contact with a human being. What about animals? What about, like, if you stuck it on a rat or something? Would it explode? That doesn't exist. I mean, it might, kind of, but no.
However...
my leg is asleep and it tingles.
My boss doesn't want me to kill you all. Yet. But I'm willing to withstand his anger at my little slip-up. Accidents do happen. You have about 20 seconds to tell me where the boy is before I lose my temper. My hand may just slip. Ariana mimed tossing the explosive. I was going to ignore it, but thanks for pointing it out.
Yeah, I was so close.
Green shook his head as Gold tried to make him see sense.
No!
Yes!
Green whispered, tears running down his face. He needed to do this. Well, at least he... is he doing a suicide move thing going on?
Yeah.
Well, at least he had told Red how he felt about him. At least Red knew he loved him. At least Red loved him back. At least... Gold shook him silently, his voice frantic.
You can't, Green. They'll kill you if they find out.
Then at least I died doing something. Change of plans. Start the riot now, boys.
Green said, realizing as he wiped his eyes that he could only run for it, and he didn't want them all to be killed before they even had a chance to do anything. So he's making the other two who were in on this plan like cause like a scene, like start a fight, I guess. And then Green is gonna run for it and hope that they kill him and think he's red or something and blow him up.
Oh my god, okay.
Or something like that. That's what's happening. Green said, realizing as he wiped his eyes that he could only run for it now and blah, blah, blah. And he didn't want them all to be killed before they even had a chance to do anything. Green stomped on Gold's foot, causing the stronger male to... So Gold is stronger than Green, too? Green is a champion.
Yeah.
To let him go with a yell before he shoved his way through the small crowd of athletes, stepping on as many feet as he could. Green dug his heel in the process, just to rile them all up further. Flint cried out, shoving Volkner into Lance, who toppled into several others, who swore loudly.
This isn't gonna work. Like, in a real situation, the person with the fucking bombs would be like, okay, bye, dumbasses. See ya.
This is Volkner and Flint. Are those both me?
No, I was Flint.
Okay. Which one's first? Volkner, Flint.
Yeah. Don't shove me, you dick!
You fucking stepped on me first!
Watch it! If you hadn't suggested we give the boy up...
You can shut the hell up, because I just said it as a suggestion. Watch yours, you motherfucker, and I'll watch mine.
That's like a different voice completely.
Okay.
Volkner seethed, actually punching Flint hard, and the afro-haired man coughed with a smirk, taking a swing, but hitting Gold, who with a roar of annoyance leapt on Norman, dealing him a heavy punch.
Oh,
Skyla was screaming as Maylene tackled her, and Flannery so that a lot of them were probably in on the plan, I guess. As Maylene tackled her, and Flannery trying to fend off Jasmine, who clawed at her, both tricked into thinking the other had stepped on her foot, so those two aren't in on the plan. They're just, like, attacking each other. Green ducking through Sylan and Drayden, who were trying to restore order, but were overwhelmed as Cynthia pinned Wallace with a shout, tears running down her face. Green shoved past Ariana roughly, who shrieked, dropping the explosive, which rolled away from her grasp, and the several rocket grunts, and was out the door running. The blood-haired lady recovering as she realized what had happened, the broken-nosed leader grunt from before with a silver-lined hat tapping her on
Give
the shoulder.
Give him a name, please.
Yeah. The broken-nosed leader grunt with the silver hat. Or just refer to him as the one, the leader grunt, or like, the silver hat. One, I don't really care.
Something better.
Stop
than that.
Using all descriptions.
Seriously.
The fight well and truly breaking out amongst the athletes, dragging some rocket members in who came too close as she and her sidekick stepped back. Her sidekick is fine.
I like that.
As the brawl got dirtier, a little unprepared for something so violent. She could, of course, just shoot or blow up the lot, but Archer and Proton had expressed specifically that they didn't kill any of the athletes just yet. You killed, like, three of the athletes!
Exactly! God.
He wanted to bring those icons down in front of an audience, just to break the regions worldwide who were watching, just to show them the kind of power they held. Settling for stepping out of the room neatly, she looked about, swiftly ducking as a rather sharp knife, no doubt from one of her grunts, was thrown her way by Faulkner. Dusting herself off, she turned to the grunt-slash-sidekick, grabbing him by the front of his shirt and dragging him so there were nose-to-nose.
Where the hell is my bloody stepson? You told me explicitly he would be here. Where is he? And who pushed past us? I'll see him get shot. He can be the grunt, because he didn't have a voice. Oh, wait, yeah, he did. Shit. He had, like, the oi
yeah.
voice. My lady, that was the late boss's son. This is not the voice.
Whatever, no.
He was the one who pushed and just ran past us with the hood and scarf. Releasing the man, she wiped her hands on her skirt. I need to beat, no flay, some manners into that filthy child. Come, rocket to me! To
rocket
me!
To me!
Leave these filthy peasants and let us be on our way.
Why are they leaving them? They can attack you and, like, kill you.
The straggling members who weren't yet unconscious from the brawl retreated, a few getting tugged back in with shrieks as they were beaten nearly to death by several furious athletes from Hoenn. As the executive walked away, she looked at her broken-nosed companion. Did you set the stick bomb in there? The man nodded, smirking, explaining how he'd stuck it near the doorway. Nodding smartly, she quickened
Everyone
her pace.
Everyone saw you do that.
Like... Good. The blast wouldn't kill the athletes, but it would cripple them further whilst trapping them very nicely. She had decided she'd like to catch up. She'd catch her stepson
as
with her
she
own...
Decided she'd like to catch
as she decided. Yeah, okay. With her own two hands. Calling up backup, she sent them after Green, who sped round corners, the hood still hiding his brunette hair and the face scarf, the fact that he was a decoy. That's it. Chapter 30.
So the hood hiding his hair and the face scarf was hiding the fact that he was a decoy. That sentence was bad.
Do you guys know what's going on?
Thoughts.
Do you? Because I don't.
Lots of things happened, but nothing happened.
Ariana Grande's in the fanfiction now, so that's cool. We at least have a celebrity.
Yeah.
Yeah, I...
There were some really just random parts of, like, unnecessary violence. I mean... It's supposed to be violent, yeah, because they're terrorists and they're attacking everyone and killing people. But it was just like random, like short little bursts of like extreme violence mixed in with like just arguing.
It was weird.
Making really stupid decisions
because they're
clearly all idiots.
Most of them. Oh my god, yeah. I don't know. I got nothing.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Arm is falling asleep. In my leg.
Like, honestly.
No.
I mean, we're still gonna keep going. We have another, I believe, 29 chapters left in this fic.
Yeah, we're over halfway.
We are over halfway.
Halfway through this chapter, we became over halfway.
Yeah, we have 29 chapters left in this fic, so we're gonna keep
plugging
away.
This is the exact middle.
But.
Chapter.
If you honestly can, like, if there's someone who watches this and, like, can figure out what we missed that's going on, please put a comment down below to help us sort of figure out where we are right now, because I don't know, and I don't think Lindsay knows either.
Don't know what?
Like, where we are and, like, what's really happening.
I don't know, they're just trapping them, I guess.
I guess.
With a sticky bomb that everyone saw him put in a doorway. Like, oh, he stuck something to the doorway. Oh, we're just gonna fight all these grunts and pay no attention to the fact that he just stuck something to the doorway. Like, in the beginning, when they came in.
It's fine.
My foot is tingly and asleep, and oh, God.
Anyways. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.
Yeah.
Join us next week. We're going to be actually taking a quick break from this, which might actually help us understand it more, because we'll have new, fresh eyes? But we'll see.
No.
But yeah, thank you guys a lot for tuning in. If you have a fic you'd like us to read, leave it down below. If you can figure out what happened in this fic, leave that comment down below, because that would really help me.
If you suggest a fic within, like, the next week or so, we might be able to read it for the next one.
Yeah. And thank you guys so much for just tuning in and all that. And, yeah, until next time, stay awesome, read more smut. Goodbye.
Bye.